But meanwhile, in. Meanwhile, in Japan, or at least bearing on what's going to happen in Japan, the Tokyo Olympics committee has decided that athletes will not be allowed to wear Black Lives Matter apparel at the games later this summer. Officials have confirmed that that's part of a ban on protests and political messages, with the IOC 2 weeks ago revealing that any sort of like demonstrations that would be done during the official ceremonies at the podium, sort of drawing attention to social or political causes, was going to be banned. But now just having the slogans or the letters or imagery on your apparel will be banned as well. Not everywhere. They do say that you'll be able to do the slogans at places like press conferences, during interviews and at team meetings. But if the messaging comes during official ceremonies, athletes could be subject to punishment. So they say, by the way, Brett, that a majority of the athletes were in favor of strict rules against demonstrations. That might even be true, but that doesn't mean that it's right. And I don't know if these athletes feel like this is their opportunity to draw attention to a cause. I'm not sure the threat of some sort of consequences is going to be enough to stop them. It might actually motivate some of them to do it.
Right, this is a stupid move. Just let it happen. Just let it happen. Like, I don't know why you would take a position either way in this, politically speaking, from the organizer's perspective. Just say, listen, you know, we're but like, if we're looking for the IOC to behave reputably, no, they're not gonna do that. The entire process by which they select what city hosts, when they host, how they host, is utterly corrupt and provably so. And it's about, and that includes like who gives the most money. And I know we got an LA Olympics coming up, and that's exactly plays into it. All the same caveats apply. So this is pretty on brand for the IOC, siding with massive moneyed interests against people trying to make a statement. Also, some of the most iconic Black Lives Matter analogous statements were made at the Olympics. 100%. And they're gonna, those moments, by the way, are gonna run in ads during the Olympics. I know there's a Visa commercial with the fist up in the air.
Yep.
That is something that is proudly touted as a result of the Olympics. Not to mention, like, entire nations have made a statement. The Olympics have been boycotted throughout history for political reasons, based on the treatment of people within those countries by the governments of those countries. So I just don't, I personally want to know who was the person in there making this a thing. I just don't get it.
I don't know. I mean, it just seems like it seems wrong, but I think more importantly, it seems incredibly counterproductive. Like, this is not going to result, I don't think, in what they want. Look, I don't know what the state of the Olympics are going to be. I don't know what they're going to look like. It's obviously going to be very different than other Olympics. Maybe things will be so able to be so carefully controlled because it won't be a typical Olympics. But that said, it's gonna happen. And then if they come down with like the hammer of Thor on one of these athletes, they're gonna look even worse. Like, they look bad now, but it's gonna be way worse once they actually do something about it. There's still time to backtrack, and I would advise that they should do that.
It is so stupid. It is so dumb. Like, I want to know who made that decision. I just don't get it. And the other thing is, there are massive like political statements being made by the athletes by American athletes every single ceremony when they walk around in the official opening ceremonies is that America is Ralph Lauren's country of choice. Like, the size of the polo player on people's shirts are like, no, we endorse product placement as a nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and popped collars for all.
Well, I already can't wait for the opening ceremonies. And I can't wait for the 2028 Olympics when Brett, and I'm definitely gonna drag Brett, he may not know it, to some women's gymnastics. It's gonna be awesome. Anyway, Brett, thank you, because it's the best.
Creepiest thing you've ever said.
The whole sports are creepy. It's awesome. It's like the most. Anyway, we'll debate it for the next 7 years or so, and then it's gonna happen. So just prepare yourself.
Okay. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.